Hi students, welcome to my channel. In this video, I am going to discuss about the chapter Logos. This chapter contains 4 marks question in intermediate level. This concept Logos is very important for other topics also. First, we have to know about what is the definition of Logos, what type of problems they are asking in examinations. We are going to discuss now. See that first, what is the definition of Logos? The set of points, the set of points in the plane satisfy the consistent geometrical condition or geometric condition. The set of points in the plane satisfy the consistent geometrical condition is called locus. For example, the set of points in the plane, I am taking here all the set of points. All the set of points satisfy the consistent geometrical condition. Suppose you take one fixed point here, that is P I am taking, C I am taking, fixed point is C, and here P1, here P2. Here P3, if you take like this, and so on, Pn, if you calculate the distance from here to here, or here to here, or here to here, or here to here, by observing the set of all points which are at a constant distance from a fixed point. So this is radius by observing the diagram. Here, what is the geometrical condition we are observing from the figure? Is generally I am writing CP instead of P1, P2, P3 and so on, PN, CP I am writing. CP is equal to R. This CP is equal to R is called geometrical condition. That means the set of all points which are satisfying the geometrical condition, CP is equal to R. Whatever we are going to apply this geometrical condition, after that we are going to get one equation. That equation is called locus related to this geometrical condition. Suppose, for example, this C point is some x1, y1, P point is x, y. The distance between them is R. CP is equal to R. CP, squaring on both sides, CP square is equal to R square. CP square means distance between these two points. So, here square is there means without root you have to write x minus x1 whole square plus y minus y1 whole square is equal to r square. This is the equation related to this geometrical condition. This is called equation of locus of point P. This is called geometrical condition for the required locus. After that, what type of questions related on locus? See that I am writing here concept wise. Type of questions on locus. Which type of questions they are asking regularly in intermediate level, either in Andhra Pradesh or Telangana, in other CBSC 11th or 12th, what they are asking? The first type, right angled triangle. So the rough diagram will be like this. Here point P, here I am taking A, here I am taking B. Find the locus of P, they will give 2 points, find the locus of P if the given points forms a right-angled triangle. Whenever right-angled triangle concept is given, you have to apply what is the geometrical condition. For any question of locus, geometrical condition is very much required. So, here according to this diagram, Pythagoras theorem application you have to do that. So PA square plus PB square equal to PA square plus PB square is equal to AB square. Whenever they are asking right angle model. Second one, the area of triangle. The area of triangle PAB is some constant. That is, triangle PAB is equal to some k units. You have to write the formula for area of triangle PAB formed by three vertices. Next, the third model, difference of distances. Difference of distances is constant. How they will ask the question? The condition will be differences means PA minus PB or PB minus PA. That is the reason mod PA minus PB is equal to some constant. This is the geometrical condition for this type of question. Next, fourth one, sum of distances is constant. That is, geometrical condition we have to write as PA plus PB is equal to K. Here no need to take modulus, right? Because PB plus PA or PA plus PB is same. PA plus PB is equal to some constant. Fifth one, ratio problems. Ratio problems. Ratio problems means the distances are in the ratio. The distances are in the ratio. K is to L or L is to M, anything. We can write as PA is to PB is equal to K is to L. Last one, sixth model, standard type, standard questions. What is the meaning of standard question, please? They will give geometrical condition. You have to write the locus for the condition. They will give like this. PA square plus PB square equal to 2PC square. It is not Pythagoras theorem application. They will give A point, B point, C point. You have to assume that locus point. After that, you can apply this geometrical condition. That is called standard questions. PA square plus PB square plus 2PC square. Till now we discussed about the types of questions on locus. Six types we discussed. Now, all the types, one example I am going to explain now by taking one and all. See, first question, find the equation of locus of P if the line segment joining 2, 3 and -1, 5 subtend a right angle at P. So, right angle concept. By observing the question, line joining points is given and it subtend a right angle at P. So, in all the locus problems, first step, that is, let P of x, y be any point on the locus. You have to assume that. First step, always, let P of x, y be any point on the locus. This is the first step in all locus problems. Second step, write about the given points. So, given points. They did not mention names, means you have to give that names. One is A, another one is B. So, A of 2, 3 and B of -1, 5. According to the question, subtend a right angle at P. So, rough diagram compulsory, you have to draw that. This is the right angle. Here P point I am assuming. This locus point only P. P of x, y. After that you can assume wherever, either here AB or here B. You can wish. Your wish, that is. A equal to 2, 3 I am writing. B here I am taking -1, 5. Exactly, right angle, subtended right angle means triangle PAB is right angle only. This is called geometrical condition. Third step. Triangle PAB is right angled. Then we have geometrical condition. PA square plus PB square is equal to AB square. Now in this PA square, PB square, AB square, substitute the respective values. What is the meaning of PA square? Distance between these two whole square. Whenever square is there without root, distance between two points you have to write. That is, in place of PA square I am writing E bracket. PA square, x minus 2 whole square plus y minus 3 whole square plus PB square, x minus or minus 1, x plus 1 whole square plus y minus 5 whole square, which is equal to AB square, distance between these two, 2 minus or minus 1, 2 plus 1 whole square plus 3 minus of 5, that means 3 minus 5 is minus 2 whole square. So expansion you have to do, that implies x square minus 4x plus 4, a minus b whole square expansion, plus y square minus 6y plus 9, plus x square plus 2x plus 1, plus y square minus 10y plus 25 is equal to 2 plus 1, 3, 3 square is 9, 3 minus 5, minus 2 whole square is 4. On both sides, 9 you have to cancel it. Even 4 also, here also, here 4. X square plus x square, 2x square. Next y square terms, y square plus y square, 2y square. Next x terms, minus 4x plus 2x. Minus 4x plus 2x is minus 2x. Minus 6y minus 10y, minus 16y. Next constants, 1 plus 25, 26. Is equal to 0. All our multiples of 2 only, you know, dividing by 2, it will becomes x square plus y square minus x minus 8y plus 13 equal to 0. Therefore, last conclusion step, the locus of P is, or P of x comma y is, same answer you have to write, x square plus y square minus x minus 8y plus 13 equal to 0. Next, I will come with another model, the area of triangle concept. Next question. Capital A of 5,3 and B of 3,-2 are two fixed points. Find the equation of locus of P so that the area of triangle PAB is 9. For all the locus problems, first point is, let P of x comma y be any point on the locus. This is the first step for all locus problems. Next step, given points A of 5,3 and B of 3,-2. Here only observe carefully. This is the turning step. Geometrical condition is given. No? What geometrical condition is given? The area of triangle PAB is 9. Given geometrical condition, or simply given condition. Triangle PAB, that means the area of triangle PAB is equal to 9. No need to write square units and all. Triangle PAB, that means the area of triangle PAB is equal to 9. Area of triangle formula, you have to write it. That is, area of triangle formula, half into x1 into y2 minus y3 plus x2 into y3 minus y1 plus x3 into y1 minus y2 is equal to 9 units. That means 9. After writing the formula, observe carefully. Given points are there, no? A and B. Here, one first point is x1, y1. Second point is x2, y2. Sir, third point is what? Third point is obviously p of x, y. That you can assume that x3, y3. So, in place of x, y, you have to write x3, y3. Substitute in this. Before going to do that, here 2, we can take this side. 9, 2 is 18. Cross multiply. Mod x1. X1 value is what? 5. Into y2 minus y3. Y2 means minus 2. Minus y3 means y. Plus x2. X2 means 3. Y3 minus y1. Y3 value is y. Minus y1 value is 3. Plus x3 is x. Y1 minus y1 value is 3. Minus y2. Minus of minus 2. Mod equal to 9 to the 18. 2 we are taking this side. Mod 5 into minus 2, minus 10. 5 into minus y, minus 5y. Plus 3 into y, 3y. 3 into minus 3, minus 9. 3 plus 2, 5. 5 into x, 5x. Which is equal to 18. After that, first these mod values, first write in the order x, y and constant. Mod x value. What are the x values here? Only 5x. Next y values, minus 5y plus 3y, minus 2y, minus 10, minus 9, minus 19 is equal to 18. That implies, if you remove modulus, this side plus or minus you have to write. Therefore, 5x minus 2y minus 19 equal to plus or minus 18. After that, which implies that 5x minus 2y minus 19 is equal to plus 18 and 5x minus 2y minus 19 equal to minus 18. Here 18 we are taking this side. 5x minus 2y minus 19 minus 18 equal to 0 and 5x minus 2y minus 19 plus 18 equal to 0. So 5x minus 2y minus 37 equal to 0 and 5x minus 2y minus 1 equal to 0. Till here completed, but conclusion step you have to write. Therefore, the locus of P, the locus of P of x comma y is the product of these two is called the required locus, is 5x minus 2y minus 37 into 5x minus 2y minus 1 equal to 0. Dear students, thank you for watching my videos. Please do subscribe, and in the coming video I am going to discuss differences of distance between the points, locus related problems and some of the distances and ratio problem on standard type questions. In the coming video, we are going to discuss. Any doubts are there regarding this, you can write to my inbox. I will respond in the proper time. Thank you very much.